Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Check out this sequence of moon phases that will be visible over the next 7 days. As the moon moves from a thin crescent past first quarter and onto a waxing gibbous phase by the weekend. Notice anything? Watch again, but look down here at the southern tip of the moon. What happens? Because of a number of factors, including the tilt of its orbit, the fact that its orbit is elliptical, and that observers aren't viewing the moon from the center of the Earth, we see something called libration. This is a rocking of the moon's appearance to observers on Earth over time, allowing us to peek around the poles and eastern and western edges and see up to 59% of the lunar surface. We've looked at many of the northern features in the past, such as Mare Crisium, Hercules, and Atlas, so instead let's head to the southern, more cratered part of the moon for some fantastic, deeply shadowed areas. Look for Hummel, a multi-cratered area right along the shadowed terminator on Monday evening. This crater is named for Johann Hummel, a 16th century German mathematician and astronomer, who was a teacher of Danish astronomer Tycho Brahe. The crater is one of the largest ones on the moon at 125 kilometers across, but the oblique angle from which we see it causes it to appear somewhat slimmer than the large ones we view more face on. The shadows on this day accentuate not only this crater, but the one immediately adjacent to its north, Pitiscus, named for another German mathematician who was also a contemporary of Brahe. An evening later, these craters are still quite prominent. And on Tuesday, look for the 90 to 100 kilometers across craters of Theophilus, Cyrillus, and Catharina. With central mountain peaks and interior craters, they are easy to find and well worth the view at higher magnification. Use most any small telescope at 75 to 100 times or greater magnification for fantastic views. And now this week's dark sky fact. How often do you wake up tired in the morning? Other than not getting to bed early enough and other easily changed habits like consuming caffeine or alcohol too close to bedtime, an issue that may be causing poor sleep is too much of the wrong kind of light before going to bed. Learn more at this website, sleepinthedark.com. On Wednesday, the depth of Pitiscus is evident from the still-shadowed eastern wall of the crater, but along the terminator, more fascinating views abound. The large and complex walled plains of Morolicus to the east and Stuffler immediately to its west are quite the highlights to observe, clocking in at 114 and 137 kilometers in diameter, respectively. Stuffler is perhaps the more intriguing one, as it has a floor flooded with lava. Look for this a day or more later. The darker floor should make this crater stand out slightly from the nearby ones. On the 5th, the moon is at first quarter phase and the lunar X will be visible, but the next evening brings another incredible appearing feature on the moon, the straight wall. On the eastern side of Mare Nubium, this lunar fault is a section where the lunar surface is slumped, on the western side, by some 250 to 300 meters in height. However, despite the cliff-like look of the feature, it's more accurately a gentle slope of just 7 degrees or so. The steep angle of a rising sun on the moon's surface provides that steep-shadowed look, but that's an illusion from our perspective. In the 17th century, the Dutch astronomer Christian Huygens likened the straight wall and the curved feature just to its south as appearing like a sword. Some still refer to this area as Huygens' sword, although the straight wall's official name is the Latinized Rupes Recta. Under the right lighting conditions, Rupes Recta appears to be surrounded by a nearly circular region within Mare Nubium. Sometimes referred to as Ancient Thebet, which is an unofficial name, it is likely the result of a previous impact that the lava has flooded over. Still, it's a somewhat intriguing area to peruse and consider the forces at work which created the wonderful view that we have today. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.